Welcome back, everybody. Today is Thursday, October the 3rd, 2019. Today we're going to be working on Giant Box, number 27. Welcome to Fred Sanford's Vintage Sewing Machine Parts, where I've been opening up boxes and boxes of vintage and some new sewing machine parts. On the sidelines, I have three boxes ready, smaller boxes. Take in whatever this box has to offer. We're gonna make this easy. Get rid of that lip. All right. Last video, I just gave away six of these. Free motion darning feet with orders for the first six members that replied. All right. Let's see. Start off with this. It's a Singer box. And there's stuff in it. Let me get my glasses on. Oh, that's better. Not much in it. Probably came with a 400 series or a 500 series. Maybe 600. I don't know what that goes to. That's probably 600, I'm thinking. Oh, we got the little plastic quilting foot. Definitely slant shank. Cool. These break a lot, so let me see here. I actually have a couple people requesting. Okay. I have to check that out. There might be some issues with that one. Let's see what else. Another Singer box. Ta-da! What's in it? Ooh! Let's rub it for good luck. Oh yeah, that's right. Gotta be careful with these. Alright. This is a 600 series, or 700. Got the large spool pins for the touch and sew, as well as some needle plates. Oh, cool. Zipper foot, some cams there. Got some of the white cams. I want to say, yep, flexi stitch. And then a couple with the black numbers. That's 57, 59, 52. Cool. Let me know if someone wants the box, everything in it. Wow, look at this. All right, this lip is annoying me. Goodbye. What's this? $29.95. Don't sound too unreasonable. Kind of flimsy. Plastic. Foot pedal. Probably newer machine. I don't know. Whatever that goes to, just a one hole. One hole. Not working. Probably the bulb inside. Probably because it's cheap. Alright. Not working. Okay. Just some miscellaneous sewing machine parts. scary. Let me just try one glove. Okay, a light assembly. Just some internal parts. It looks like someone took a machine apart. Who knows what they go to? Broken bobbin winder assembly. Just what? I'll keep the bobbin case out. What a mess. We'll get to that. We'll attend to that later. All right, we kept the one good part. How we looking? Wow. A motor. What is this? From a 99. Singer 99. Motor. Light. Foot pedal. The 99s came with this foot pedal as well as a couple other ones. And boy, that one is rusty. This is missing the bracket. Might still be on the machine. Other than that, it looks good. The pedal don't look very good. All right. That was really dusty. Okay, a motor with very bad wiring, so. Some white flexi stitch cams. I'm not sure, it's 700 series. Oh, cool. You got the genuine low shank quilting foot with guy. You don't see these very often. You got the touch and, you know what? You know what this looks like? This looks like a creative touch bobbin, not a touch and so. They look a lot alike. Except for the black lines around it. What else uses it besides Creative Touch? What's the name of that one? Oh, I can't think of it. But yeah, they look a lot alike. These always look like they got a crack in them. But it's not. That's just the way they are. Alright. Well, cool. That's just the bottom, I guess. Didn't have a top. All right, cool, man. How much? Almost 10 minutes. Another one of these. Kind of the same story. Wow, the rare number 3 top hat cam. This is only good for certain touch and sew machines. Wow. It does exist! Woohoo! Man, look at that. Orange. That is too cool. Any more rare ones in here? No. 14. No. I need number 17. Come on, 17! Mm-hmm. 21, that's a common cam. I got a bunch of 21s. This one looks weird. Oh, this is for... They look like a top hat. The imposter. They're a little fatter. Well, they are a top hat, but they're a little different than this one. I think they work on just certain touch and soles. A little different. They're a little different. You gotta watch your eyes out for those. There's a chart somewhere out there that you can look up. I've looked at it a couple times. What those all go to, and I can always go back to it to refer to it. And there's another one. The imposter. We'll have to look that up. Well, a lot of, if anybody's looking for the white flexi stitch cams, let me know. Oh, that's an interesting foot. Very interesting. That was fun. Okay. Woohoo! Let's do it again. Deja vu. Didn't I just keep opening these boxes? Let me guess. It says it right on the top. It's from us. A golden touch and sole, 640. With the wrong bobbin in it. With the first generation class 66 bobbin. Yes. Yes. It's like hitting gold. Hard to find these without rust. You got a lot of steel in them. Listen to that. Yeah. Same story. Down below, flexi sticks. Any imposter cams. Hey, I'm running out of room. Oh, I should show you guys. Kind of the same story. Some needle plates. Straight sticks. And the zigzag. We got the big spool pin. The big spool pin. We got some touch and sew bobbins. And the touch and sew. Well, this was a hint here. Flexi stitch used on the touch and sew 640. Alright, good to know. Good to know. Why didn't they put numbers on all the bobbins? Like this one. Hey, where's the bottom? This one says 6. What's a 706? 726. Those models do not sound familiar. I know they're touch and sole 700 series, but a 706. Same story. Some bobbins, some feet, the overcast foot, button foot, the smaller spool pin. I'm not sure what that one's used for. The smaller spool pin. What do they call this one? All-purpose? Not all-purpose. I can pick it up. Special foot, sand stitch. It's small, it's hard to hold it. Got some cool tools, little screwdriver, little cleaning brush. Nice. Little tiny bobbin case screwdriver. Oh no, it's not. That's a wild screwdriver. Can anybody see that? It's so wild I don't know if it's broken or what, or if it's made that way. Back it up. It's like a pitchfork. Alright, that was just too much, too fun. And the top. We're gonna say that goes to that. That looks right. A bunch of these. They must have been storing them in the same spot. I don't even remember. I don't know if I loaded this or my buddy did. We got a slant shank roller foot. That's what it appears to be. Got one of these things. More of the flexi stitch. Touch and sew cam. No number on it. Ooh, we're building a nice tower. Might as well keep going. Hey, another one of these Singer guides. It's kind of pretty cool. Got inches on one side, and this must be, not sure what that is, millimeters? Millimeters? Yeah, inches and millimeters. Very interesting. I like that. Those might come in handy. We have a Singer three-hole foot pedal. $15. Yours. It'll be tested and cleaned. And cleaned and tested. Same story. Flexi stitch. Oh, some of the Creative Touch and other machines with the black circles around them. And some mystery item. Mystery item. Some mystery, very mysterious item. We'll get rid of that. Cool. These boxes don't work very good. The lids keep wanting to pop off. Might as well keep going with them. Where are we at? 17 minutes. Yay! How did I know? Flexi stitch cams. And one of these things. I should know what it's called. Singer needles. Zipper foot. Hey. Any more? Ooh, look at all the good stuff. Wow. Ooh, yeah. Oh, yeah. What's in here? From Singer to Kenmore. Green case. All right. Woohoo, it's like gold. You know, these are very hard to find. So we got, now we have, they're double-sided, by the way. They're 4A. We have 4. We have 6. We have 1. 5. What are we missing? We're missing 2. And 8. I believe there's 8 cams in this set. So we're missing 2 and 8, but that's nice. Very nice find. Everything's in there. Wow. The bobbin case, the bobbin, some needles, the shuttle, a attachment, and oh, cool. Some genuine 7 hole bobbins. That's nice. Very nice. Very nice. Yep. A lot of stuff in here. Buttonholer. Okay. Anything else, Kenmore? How about a book? How about a manual? Model 85. Model 85. Anybody need to let me know. Mysterious box. Says free motion. That's good. Boy, that's a thick baggie. To fit the 66... Elizabeth! What is it? It's a darning and embroidery attachment. Don't look like, is that it? Man, why'd they tape the book like that? Well, here's the book. I've never seen one before. You think it's worth $1,000? And all my dreams will come true? $1,000. $1,000. What is it? It's a darning and embroidery attachment. You all know what it's for. Flat piece of metal. I can't see it being worth a whole lot. But, you know, if someone wants to give me $1,000 for it, I don't think I'll complain. That's a nice find. I'm going to look that one up. Anything else cool in here? Yes!